We're going to go ahead and continue since 5-4 is still multiplication. So really both of these videos go together because it's multiplication. The only difference is 5-4 is what's called a special products. So in this case, they're actually going to talk about foiling, which we already did. So it's not a new concept. It's just now when you click on help me solve this, they're going to talk about that. And the first one here, I absolutely want you to memorize. This is super, super important. Can you do this another way? Yes. So what I want to notice is that one of them is a plus and one of them is a minus. So it's a product of a sum and difference. Doesn't matter if it's a difference and a sum and a difference. When you FOIL it out, the middle terms will cancel. So I want you to recognize that. On the test, if you FOIL it out, it's not going to be marked wrong. But you need to know how to do it for Chapter 6 and for Chapter 7. So really important that you start recognizing it and use it. And I like to refer to it as a difference of squares, which is actually going from right to left. But you'll notice here it's a difference of two squares. So if you notice, they exactly match. And one is a plus and one is a minus. One is a sum and one is a difference. You will always take the difference of the two squares. So we have 8r and 1. So 8r squared gives me, be careful, 64r squared. And 1 squared is 1. That's your answer. That's it. It seems super easy, and I want you to think of it as super easy. And I really want to stress you need to memorize it. So when you notice it fits a product of a difference and a sum where the terms are matching, I want you to remember it's a difference of squares. So 2x and 7. So this gives me 4x squared minus 49. Difference of two squares. Exactly match except for the sign. So we have a 9x quantity squared and a 2y quantity squared. So my answer here is 81x squared minus 4y to the fourth. Now, this next special case is called a square of binomials. I think it's awesome if you can memorize it this way, but I find that y'all have so much floating in your head. This one is not a tremendous savings of times. So what I want you to make sure you minimum know, so please listen to her, watch her videos. And if you can follow it, I want you to do it. Great. But if you're struggling, I want you just to realize that what does a square mean? A square means multiply it by itself. So rewrite it and FOIL. When you FOIL, you will get x squared plus xy, which is where the 2xy comes from, plus y squared. You're always going to get double the middle term, okay? That's awesome, but I think, again, a lot of y'all are better just to go ahead and rewrite it. So the second one, x minus y quantity squared, is x minus y, and FOIL it. Realizing you're going to always get a double the middle term. But I want you to, really, really important, this caution. You cannot distribute the exponent, and we wrote this down already, if there is addition or subtraction in the inside, you have to FOIL. So if you do this on a test, you're going to, again, that's a huge no-no. I can't stress enough. It's a huge, huge no-no. You will see this idea on the next test and the following test. Really important. So, again, if you want to use her format, go for it. I mean, it's totally a piece that you will see in almost every math book. But if you struggle with it, just rewrite it. When we FOIL this, we're going to get 9r squared minus 15rs minus 15rs plus 25s squared. And I do want you to recognize you do get double the middle term. So my answer here is 9r squared minus 30rs plus 25s squared. Going to my second one here, rewrite it. And I'm going to FOIL that out. That gives me 64x squared plus 40x plus 40x plus 25. And then we always, again, should expect to get a middle term that was double. So this gives me 64x squared plus 80x plus 25. That is my answer for this problem. Could you have gone directly using the format? Absolutely. It would say square the first, which is 64x squared. Multiply these together, which gives you 40x, and double it. That's where the 80x came from. And square the last. So, can you use that? Yes. And if you see it, perfect. But if you are struggling as you're mixing all of these ideas together, it doesn't take a lot more time just to write it twice and FOIL it out. But please understand there's a difference between the product of the sum and difference and the square of binomial. These do not match. One is a plus and one is a minus. One is an addition, one is subtraction. And these, if you're to rewrite them, is multiplying by the same exact value. So our last three for multiplication just kind of goes over, all right, let's use all the rules together. If you have a monomial in front, use it last, because that's just going to make the numbers bigger. So on number six, we are going to start with the parentheses, which is a product of a sum and a difference. So this is a difference of squares. So this becomes an x squared minus 16. So that's what the rules say to do. Bring down this first term, which is my monomial, and now I can distribute that. That gives me 3x to the fifth, because we add our exponents, minus 48x cubed. That is my answer. What I started with is a difference of squares, which said square the first minus square the second. So squaring x gave me x squared minus 4 squared, and then I distributed my monomial. Going to number 7, this is again what I like to refer to as a difference of squares. They don't refer to it as that in this form, but it's just kind of a piece that I think helps you to remember it. And whenever you deal with bigger exponents, I do think it helps to rewrite that step first that we were writing above. This number 6 going back, I didn't write that out because it was a pretty straightforward one. Here, I multiply my exponents because I'm using the power rule, and then 3 squared is 9. Difference of squares. Going to my last one, number 8, I'm going to keep that 3 in front. And for me, I'm going to rewrite this. If you can use our sum of squares, sum of my binomials, square of my binomials, excuse me, you can go directly to using that form. So square binomials, remember, was up here. Totally fine. If it's confusing, FOIL it out. So this is m squared minus 4mp, because remember we put them in alphabetical order, minus 4mp plus 16p squared. This 3, don't forget it. Always get double the middle term. So I get a minus 8mp plus 16p squared. And my last step here, I am going to multiply every term by 3. So I get 3m squared minus 24mp plus 48p squared. This is my answer.